Looking for outdoor window and door sensors to improve your smart home automation setup? Today I'm going to review and set up the Strips by Sensative Invisible Door and Window Sensor. Stay tuned. Hi again, John Stone, the DIY Smart Home Guy, here to let you know about a door and window sensor that's relatively new to the smart home world. The Strips sensor is a battery-operated Z-Wave Plus device that has an incredibly low profile and can be used indoors or out. Most battery-operated sensors are big and bulky, they're difficult to conceal, and the battery life is usually 1 year or less, but not the Sensative Strip. Not only are they ultra-thin, they have a 10-year battery life. 10 years. It's important to note that the Strip relies on a magnetic sensor. This means that you can only mount it on wood, aluminum, or plastic frames. My first choice was to put it outside on my gate, but since it's a wrought iron gate, that's off the table. The sensor communicates to your hub using the Z-Wave Plus protocol. One advantage to this is that the Strip can be an extended distance from the hub since Z-Wave allows you to use other power devices like switches and lights as repeaters. The manufacturer does warn that using repeaters will reduce the battery life, but who the hell knows what that means? Is it like 50%, 10%? I don't know. At the time I recorded this video, the Sensative Strip is not supported by the Wink Hub or the Wink Hub 2. However, the Sensative Strip does work with Fibaro Home Center 2, Fibaro Home Center Light, Vera Edge, SmartThings, and a few others. So I'm going to go ahead and connect this into my SmartThings Hub. Let's go up to the lab and get this thing installed. So when you first pull the Sensative Strip out of the box, it's going to have this square magnet on one side, and it's going to have this round magnet on the other side. The round magnet will be attached to the round end. It'll be taped on there. And then that square magnet will be taped on this square edge right here. So what you're going to do inside your app is you're going to do the add a thing. Then you're going to do an add device manually. And we're going to scroll down here to sensors. And then we're going to have open and close sensors. And at the bottom of that list, we're going to have Sensative Strips. Once you have this on the screen, you're going to hit the connect now. It's going to be looking for devices. You're going to pull both of those magnets off, and it's automatically going to go into pairing mode, and it should get picked up right into your SmartThings Hub. Right here, I have this called open window. Now it's saying that my sensor is open. When this contact plate, so nice, you have the logo on it and everything. When that covers up the logo on the strip, you'll see that on the app, that went to closed. So go to open, open, goes pretty fast, and then you're gonna go to closed, and it's as simple as that. Now, the other thing I wanna point out is we said that you have that 1.4 centimeters, so let's look at that in the app. I'm gonna put that magnet right there, maybe just about a centimeter away, and you'll see there in the app that it went to closed. So you do have a little bit of distance. If you come back, let's go maybe about a half an inch there, still closed. And we're gonna come off there. I'm almost an inch away, still showing closed. And then we go there to open. So you do have a little bit to play with. If I try to go through my finger, if you have too much in the way, it's gonna be a little sketchy, but you see there it went back to closed, so we're okay there. Now that this is set up in the app, I'm going to mount this into my window. The kit comes with this little towelette that you can use to clean the surfaces that you plan to adhere the strip and the magnet to. Make sure that the surface is very clean, that you have the necessary clearances, and I recommend that you do a few test fits before you mount the sensor.
Okay, so we're gonna take our little towelette here, and I'm gonna put the strip on this side of the window. Let's get that all nice and clean. Looky crap. I'm gonna put the magnet on the inside here. So get that all nice and clean. All right, but I've got this stop. I'm gonna put that magnet right here on that stop, okay? All right. I'm gonna put that in. I'm gonna slide it all the way to the bottom so I have no worries about where that's gonna end up. So there it is down on the bottom of that jam there. And remember, this is what I'm trying to make contact with right here. So that's going to be about an inch off the bottom of that. I'm going to come about an inch off that jam, right in the center.
There's that.
I should be able to close this window. Open that up. Right now on the iPhone, you see that that office window is open inside my SmartThings app. And we're just going to go ahead and give that window a close. And the app goes to closed. That's just the way it should be. Come back to open. And my window's open.
Now that this is installed, I want to connect this into Stringify so that I can do some other cool things. I installed this in my office window because I'm always forgetting to close the darn thing. I like to open the window and get some airflow through the house. The problem is this. If the AC or the heater comes on while the window is open, I'm just dumping money out the window. So my solution is this. When the window's open, I'm going to trigger a Stringify flow to turn on my TV backlight and make it green. At the same time, it'll automatically place my EcoBee3 smart thermostat to a setting that widens my high and low comfort setting range, which will prevent the thermostat from being too sensitive. This way, I'll have a constant reminder that the window is open with the green light and not have the HVAC system cycling on and off while the windows are open.
So on my TV backlight at sunset, what happens is this Stringify flow automatically triggers and it cycles my lights every 10 minutes through these various color changes. So this is kind of a nice sunset, sun's going down, let's cycle through the various colors of the sky around the time of a sunset. It'll automatically cycle ultimately through to a blue. And the blue state is where the television basically stays during the evening while we're watching TV. So now when we open the window, that's gonna turn that backlight to green. And when the window's closed, it's going to resume it back to the blue.
And on top of turning that TV backlight green, you can also see that my thermostat has switched into away mode. And when the window closes, you can see that it returns to the at-home mode.
As I've mentioned before, one cool thing about creating your custom DIY smart home is that you can save on energy costs. This solution will help me achieve that goal. Now, here's the fun part about the setup. The sensitive strip is connected to my SmartThings hub. When the sensor is triggered, it sends a notification over to Stringify. Stringify, in turn, runs a flow that controls the lights that are controlled by my Wink hub. It's just like the sensitive strip is giving commands directly to my EcoBee3. And the power of Stringify is this. My home automation is now able to control my heating and cooling system based on if I have windows open or closed. This is a much better level of control than what can be achieved through simple schedules and home versus away detection. I can also control the lights to provide a subtle indication of how the house is configured. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to click like. Over here are a couple of other videos that you might enjoy. For more reviews, tips, and DIY videos, visit azhb.com. And thanks to all of you that already follow me over on Facebook or Twitter. Both are at DIY Smart Home Guy. Until next time, cheers.